Hey everyone, and welcome back to New Suicide, where we discuss comics, movies, games, and more. My name is Ronnie, and today we're going to be discussing the top 5 things I really want to see in Marvel Spider-Man 2. Now, this can vary from game mechanics to different NPCs to combat or whatever. I know it's very vague judging from the title of this video, but it's something I need to get off my chest. So, if you all can do me a huge favor and click on that subscribe button, like, comment, and click on the bell notification, that would be amazing from you guys. I'm trying to reach 10,000 subscribers by this December. It'll definitely mean the world to me. I'm trying to actually win a bet, believe it or not, and I think it'll be possible for me to achieve the goal with your help. Also, do join my Discord. Invitation link is in the description box below, and follow me on Twitter and Instagram, to which you can find the links to that in my description box as well. With all of that being said, let's start the countdown for number 5 and work our way down. Number 5, children. Why aren't there any children NPCs in both Marvel Spider-Man and Miles Morales? Miles, Genki, and company don't count. I'm talking about the I lost my balloon variety. Stupid little You step outside of your door and go into the world, and chances are you're going to see some children running around. I mean, yeah, it's a little detail, but it makes New York City seem that much more lived in, I guess. I mean, all you see are NPC adults. Not to mention, I don't recall seeing any schools besides the ESU campus. I'm talking about high schools, of course. I just feel like if we're going to be swinging around in a big city, we need a wider variety of people in New York City. Number 4, pets. Just like the last point I was trying to prove, if you ever step outside, chances are you're going to see some people outside walking their pets. Besides the typical rats and pigeons you would expect to find in the streets of New York City, and of course the cat from Marvel Spider-Man Miles Morales, there should be dogs running about in the city, maybe a stray or something. I think it'll make New York seem that much livelier if we saw various of NPCs walking their dogs, playing fetch with them, maybe implement a feature where Spider-Man can walk up to someone's dog or something and pet them, even find a lost stray and actually try to return them to their owner. I don't know, something like that would be kind of cool. I'd like to see that. It'd be something different for a change. Number 3, other crimes besides car thief, store robbery, and kidnapping. I don't know about you guys, but it can get a bit repetitive when stopping the same crime over and over again. It's something you'd expect in a Spider-Man game. Question for you all, how often you'd expect the same crime to occur frequently? Alright, I'll shut up about that. It's a video game anyways. But seriously though, bring back saving the construction worker slipping off from the side of the building, delivering pizza maybe, or taking a person to the hospital. And speaking of hospitals, where are those? I don't remember seeing hospitals in the game. Number 2, web slingshot. I think I've mentioned this before in a previous top 5 or top 10 video, but why don't we have this? It seems like it's a typical Spider-Man thing to have in the game. I was disappointed to learn that we didn't have that trick in this game. The Spider-Man games like The Amazing Spider-Man 2 and Spider-Man 2 from 2004 had it. This time, I want to be able to slingshot myself in various types of ways, from the walls to flags, and of course, while in mid-swing. Definitely a great ability to implement in Marvel Spider-Man 2. It would totally complete the Spider-Man character as a whole. The swinging is nailed down, the air tricks as well, but I think having the ability to slingshot yourself across a few blocks adds the opportunity for us to get creative and improvise as if we were Spider-Man. And finally, at number 1, bring in a mission wheel. This idea actually comes from Pixel Sean, who makes amazing content as well. Definitely check out and subscribe to his channel. He's already almost at 1,000 subscribers. Pixel Sean brings up a great point regarding the mission wheel. Some of us don't really want to proceed with a linear path of a campaign. Sometimes you'd probably want to do said specific missions in order to progress through the game. Not that there's an actual problem with the story of Marvel Spider-Man, granted it's a great story, but if we could choose our battles, this definitely would provide the opportunity for lesser known villains of Spider-Man to shine. Now, could you imagine Screwball being one of the available missions on the mission wheel?
Look how many villagers I gained.
Shut the f up, you stupid b-. Anyways, those are my top 5 things I want to see in Marvel Spider-Man 2. You let me know what are your thoughts about my list. Are there other things you'd like to see in Marvel Spider-Man 2? Any improvements, features, or anything like that? Or anything else? You sound off down in the comment section below. Be sure to like, comment, subscribe, and click on that bell notification so you all don't miss videos like this, and I will see you all in the next comic panel.